remember now, my love, what piteous thing we saw on a summer's gracious day. By the roadside, a hideous carrion, quivering on a clean bed of pebbly clay, her legs flexed in the air like a courtesan. Humbly exposed its belly, ironic and wan, clamorous with foul ecstasy, the sun bore down upon this rottenness, as if to roast it with golden fire and render back to nature her own largesse a hundredfold of her desire. Heaven observed the haunting carcass there, blooming with the richness of a flower, and that almighty stink which corpses wear, choked you with sleepy power. The fly swarmed on a putrid vulva, then a black tumbling rout would seethe, of maggots thick like a torrent in a glen, over those rags that lived and seemed to breathe. They darted down and rose up like a wave, or buzzed impetuously as before. One would have thought the corpse was held a slave to living by the life it bore. This world had music, its own swift emotion, like water in the wind running, or a corn that a winnower in rhythmic motion fans with fiery flame. All forms receded as in a dream were still, where white visions vaguely start from the sketch of a painter's long-neglected idol into a perfect art. Behind the rocks, a restless bitch looked on, jealous eyes. Waiting to tear from the livid skeleton her loose morsel quick with flies. And even you will come to this foul shame, this ultimate infection. Star of my eyes, my being's inner flame, my angel and my passion. Shall you be, O Queen of heavenly grace, beyond the last sacrament, when through your bones the flowers and sucking grass weave their rank cerement? This dire putrescence, to the worm that shall kiss your proud estate, that I have kept the divine form and the essence of my festered love's flesh.